Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hi students, good morning. Welcome back with Miss Sari in mathematics class in grade 5. Okay, I hope you always keep your health and happiness. Okay students, today we are going to continue our topic. It's about compare and order numbers. Yeah. Hari ini kita mau membahas tentang membandingkan dan mengurutkan bilangan. Okay, next. The aim of this lesson is to compare and order numbers up to 1 million. And the success criteria, you can identify the value of each digit up to 1 million. And you can compare numbers up to 1 million. And you can order sets of number up to 1 million. Okay. Tujuan dari pembelajaran ini adalah kalian bisa mengidentifikasi nilai dari setiap digit bilangan, kemudian membandingkan dan mengurutkan bilangan hingga maksimal 1 juta. Okay, let's talk about comparing numbers. Comparing numbers is useful for working out if one number is greater or smaller than another number. Okay, membandingkan bilangan itu sangat berguna ketika kita harus membandingkan atau ada bilangan yang lebih besar dan ada bilangan yang lebih kecil. Maka kita harus bisa membandingkannya agar kemudian lebih lanjutnya kita bisa mengurutkan, bisa dari yang terbesar ataupun dari yang terkecil. And we compare numbers by looking at their digits and by understanding the place value of each digit. So, jadi kita bisa membandingkan bilangan dengan cara memperhatikan digit dari masing-masing bilangan dan kemudian memahami nilai tempat dari masing-masing digit itu. And then let's look at a simple example. Which number is greater, 23 or 230? Okay, let's see the first picture. It is represent 23, and it contains 2 tens and 3 ones. Okay, jika kita lihat 23, jika menggunakan peraga blok Diens, kita bisa lihat di sini 23 itu tersusun dari 20-an dan 3 satuan, right? And then the second picture represent 230. There are 200s, ada 200-an dan 30-an or 3 tens. Nah, we can see that 230 is greater than 23. Okay, jadi dari gambar ini terlihat bahwa 230 itu lebih besar atau lebih banyak daripada 23. Terlihat dari kubus-kubus yang terbentuk di sini ya. 230 otomatis jumlah kubus yang ada itu lebih besar atau lebih banyak daripada yang 23. Okay, next. A place value grid can also help the visualize the comparison. Jadi perbandingan bilangan itu bisa menggunakan tabel nilai tempat. Okay, let's see. I have two numbers. Please answer me which is greater. Manakah yang lebih besar? 235,283 or 235,822. Let's see the first for 235,283. Let's see from the place value chart. Okay, di sini kita lihat ada tabel nilai tempat. Kemudian kita letakkan masing-masing dari angka atau digit bilangan ini. Okay, first, let's put, yeah, for the 100,000 is 2, right? Yes, and then we put 2 here, and then for the 10,000, we put 3, okay? Because the 10,000 is 3, and then the 1,000 is 5, and then we put 5 circle here, and so on. The 100 is 2, and the 10s is 8, and the 1s is 3. And then next, for the second numbers is 235,822. Okay, let's put each digit into the place value chart first. Okay, let's see. 2 is 100,000. And then 3 is in 10,000. 5 is in 1,000. And then 8 is in hundreds. And then 2 first is in tens, and the last 2 is in ones. Okay. Now, we need to compare the place value of the digits in each number. To do this, we always start with the digit on the left. And be careful to check the place value of each digit in each number. We then compare the value of each digit until the numbers are different. Jadi, salah satu caranya adalah dengan membandingkan dari nilai tempat di dalam tabel nilai tempat ini. Kita
okay,
mulai
now let's see the step by step of each digit.
First, both numbers have 200 thousands. This doesn't help us compare the numbers, so we move to the next digit. Kedua bilangan ini, 100 thousand-nya sama-sama 2. Maka, ini tidak akan membantu kita untuk bisa membandingkan mana yang lebih besar, mana yang lebih kecil. Okay, let's go to the next. What about the 10 thousands? Bagaimana dengan yang puluhan ribu? The 10 thousands is 3 for the left side and 3 also in the right side. So it's not help us. Okay, and then what about the thousands? Let's see, the thousands is 5 and here is 5 too. So let's go to the next digit. Nah, the hundreds. The left side, the hundreds is 2. And for the right side, the hundreds is 8. Nah, so we have found it. Okay, 800 is bigger than 200. We don't need to look at any more of the digits as we have found a difference between the two numbers. Jadi karena kita sudah menemukan perbedaannya dan 800 ini lebih besar dari yang 200, maka kita tidak perlu lagi melanjutkan membandingkan di digit berikutnya. Okay, jadi sudah langsung bisa ditemukan jawabannya. So, 235,822 is greater than 235,282. Okay. Nah, let's try to do exercises related to comparing number. Okay, I have some numbers. Which number is greater in this pairs? Jadi di sini ada pasangan-pasangan bilangan. Kalian Miss Mita untuk membandingkan manakah yang lebih besar. If you are correct, the number will turn blue. Nanti kalau jawaban kalian benar, maka warnanya akan berganti dengan warna biru. Okay, let's check. The first pairs. Pasangan yang pertama. 56,211 and 54,211. Please look at the digits, each digit of the number. First, 10,000 is 5, and then for the thousands, here is 6 and here is 4. It means that 6 is greater than 4. So I think the answer is this one is bigger. Yeah, that's right. So this 56,211 is greater than this one. Okay, next. The next number. 123,984 or 123,948. Okay, I think I have found the difference. Yeah, in the tens. Perbedaannya kita temukan di bagian puluhannya. 8 is greater than 4. So I think the answer is this one. Let's check. Yeah, that's correct. And then let's check for the third. 762,482 or 762,184. I will try to find out which one is greater. Okay, I have found the difference. I find the hundreds. Misalnya temukan di bagian ratusannya. This is 4 and this is 1. So I think this is the bigger. Yeah, that's correct. And what about this one? 375,121 or 378,121. I think this one. Yes, because 8 is greater than 5. Okay, the last one. 484,448 or 484,884. Okay, let's check which one is greater. Let's check the digit. 448 and this is 884. Okay, now I have found it. This is the 100. The 100 is 8 and here is 4. So the answer is this one. Okay. Okay, now in the comparing number,
we usually use this symbol, right? For the greater than and less than. We can use this symbol to compare number. Can you recall what this number, this symbol means and how we use them? This symbol means less than. And the narrow part of the symbol points to the smaller number. Jadi tanda ini, bagian yang runcing, akan menunjuk ke bilangan yang lebih kecil. And then this symbol means greater than. The wider part of the symbol opens up towards the larger number. Oke, bagian yang membuka itu akan mengarah ke bilangan yang lebih besar. Oke, now let's try to practice using the symbol for the greater than and less than. Okay, now, please compare these two numbers, 539289 or 593289. Okay, I think I have found the answer. This one is bigger or greater than. So, I think the symbol, the white arrow is go to the right. Yes, that's right. Okay, next, 374284 or 347248. Okay, I have found it. I think this is greater. So the wider part will go to the left. Let's see. Yes. Okay, now the next. 5763 or 5378. Okay, I have found this. This one, the hundreds is 7 and this one, the hundred is 3. So, I think this is greater. So, the symbol will be go to the left. Okay, now, the 464464 or 464646. Okay, I think this one is greater. So, the symbol is go to the right. Correct one. Okay, it should be like this. Yeah, okay, let's talk about the worksheet that you have to do. This is the first worksheet. The topic is about comparing number. First, please put the symbol of greater than, less than, or equal. And then the second one, you should compare the number and please circle the largest number. Okay, choose which one is the largest. And then the third part, you have to circle the smallest number, okay? Okay, kids, I think it's enough for today, and I hope you do your worksheet until finished and stay happy and healthy. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Moms and Dads sedang mencari sekolah yang nyaman dan berkualitas untuk si kecil? Hari ini telah dibuka penerimaan siswa baru, playgroup dan TK terpadu Budi Mulia 2 Seturan. Dilengkapi dengan fasilitas yang lengkap, playground luas berstandar Eropa, kolam renang, ruang kelas yang nyaman dan luas, ditambah dengan kurikulum bilingual Islamic Montessori yang dikemas menjadi kurikulum Budi Mulia 2, menjadikan belajar tetap menyenangkan. Sesuai moto kami, bersekolah dengan senang dan senang di sekolah.